There's a player that never gets mentioned among the greats of the NFL. What if I told you this guy played in the 1940s and the 1970s, retired the all-time scoring leader, and was even the first fantasy draft pick ever? Yeah, he's more than a Jeopardy clue. We're about to take you on the most interesting roller coaster the NFL has ever seen, George Blanda's career. Blanda's football life started out just like anyone else in the mid-40s. He was the starting quarterback and kicker for the University of Kentucky Wildcats. But after that, it gets pretty weird. Among the list of famous names he runs across, Blanda was the starter for Bear Bryant's Kentucky team from 1945 to 48. That's right, before he was an Alabama legend, Bear Bryant was coaching none other than George Blanda. Blanda was around for the rise of UK, who was a basement dweller until Bryant got there. Blanda slipped to the 12th round of the 49 draft. At 22 years old, Blanda was drafted to George Halas's Chicago Bears. Instead of a signing bonus, Blanda was given a $600 loan that he was forced to give back when he signed his rookie contract. Blanda became the Bears' backup quarterback and primary kicker. You just don't get many chances when Sid Luckman is the team's quarterback. Pretty simple. In spot duty, Blanda was pretty awful, throwing 5 picks on only 21 attempts as a rookie. In his second season, strange things happened. Because the Baltimore Colts couldn't field an entire team, they traded for Blanda. He only played one game with the Colts before they tried to turn around and trade him to Green Bay. Hearing about this, Halas vetoed the trade, forbidding them from trading Blanda to a rival team. Blanda was then brought right back to the Bears. He wouldn't see the field until 1953, where he would be the Bears' starter for 2 seasons. In the NFL, he never threw for more touchdowns than picks, and only started a little more than half of the games. Blanda would never get another shot with the Bears, relegated to kicking duties. Halas and Blanda's relationship was so bad that at one point, the crowd was chanting to put Blanda in at the tail end of a blowout game, and Halas called Blanda's name down on the sideline. As George ran up, throwing his helmet on, Halas pointed to the stands and said, "Get up there, they're calling for you." What would be considered a solid career in the NFL, Blanda got tired of being only a kicker and retired in 1958. So if you're keeping score at home, that's 9 seasons at the age of 31. This is probably the end of most NFL careers, but then the name of this video would be a lie. In 1960, a new league was formed, the American Football League. With a shot at being a quarterback, Blanda returned to football with the Houston Oilers. Initially seen as an NFL cast-off, he was an immediate success. In the AFL's inaugural season, Houston won the AFL championship. Blanda followed that up with possibly the best season of his career, throwing for 36 touchdowns in 1961, winning both the AFL MVP and repeating as AFL champions. As we'll find out, George Blanda is a history maker, though not always the best history. In 1962, Blanda threw a still-standing record of 42 interceptions. Throughout the next few seasons, Houston and George Blanda threw the ball more than anyone else. A 4-time AFL All-Star, Houston looked for some younger blood and moved on from George Blanda, cutting him in 1967. Score update. Blanda is now a 17-year vet at 39 years old. The Oakland Raiders desperately needed a dependable backup and a competent kicker, and Blanda was just the man for the job. He played for Oakland into the 70s. His kicking, along with the Raiders' success, led to Blanda's appearance in Super Bowl II. Blanda remained the kicker into 1970, where Blanda saw the NFL and AFL merger. 1970 was the finest hour of Blanda's career. Another score update. In 1970, Blanda was 43 years old and a 20-year pro. When Oakland absolutely needed Blanda, he came in clutch every time. Off the bench, he threw for 3 touchdowns and added a field goal against the Steelers to win a crucial game. Against the Chiefs, his 48-yard kick tied up the game in the waning moments. With the game on the line, Blanda came in clutch with both his arm and his foot. Blanda's late-game touchdown to tie was only capped off by a 52-yard game-winning boot to defeat the Cleveland Browns. Add in game-winning touchdown passes and field goals against Denver and San Diego, and Grandpa Blanda's heroics took the Raiders to the first-ever AFC Championship game. When Raiders quarterback Daryl LaMonica got hurt again, Blanda came in to relieve him. Blanda became the oldest quarterback to ever play in a championship game. The Raiders fell short, but Blanda was named the AP Athlete of the Year. While 1970 was Blanda's last year in the limelight, he continued as the Raiders kicker. It would be another six seasons before Blanda retired in 1976. And he only retired because he was beat out by a younger kicker. His last kick was in the AFC Championship game, adding to his huge lead in all-time postseason scoring. And for our final score update, Blanda's 48 years of age and 26 seasons in the league are both records. Blanda played in four different decades, from the 40s into the mid-1970s. Blanda retired the all-time point scorer in history, and in his 959 career extra point attempts, he only missed 16. His 98% accuracy helped him become the all-time point after scorer in the history of football. George Blanda's records and accolades stand next to any before or after him, and his football life was enshrined in the NFL Hall of Fame in 1981. Not many people leave the game the all-time interceptions leader and the only player with 2,000 points scored. I mean, he even picked off a pass once. While Tom Brady might unseat him as the oldest player ever, and we hope he does, no one will ever come close to the crazy story of the oldest player in NFL history. Thank you, George Blanda. So, there you have it, the oldest player in NFL history. Do you guys think Tom Brady will outlast George Blanda and become the new oldest player in NFL history? Let me know what you guys think in the comments section down below. We'll catch you next time.